Let us take this data interpretation question, which is XCAT question 2008 CAT. So as you can see, there are six colleges and we want to get calls from these colleges. There are four sections and each section has got a sectional cutoff, which is given in a kind of a table, which college has what number sectional cutoff pertaining to that particular section. So as you can see, college 1, the sectional cutoff for section A is 42, for section B is 42, and for section C is 42. Whereas there is no sectional cutoff requirement for section D as far as college 1 is concerned. Now there is aggregate cutoff as well, which is 176 marks. So any student who scores more than 42 in section A or more than 42 in section B, more than 42 in section C, and scores more than 176 overall, is eligible to get a call from college 1. That is the interpretation of the table. So all these marks are out of 50 and the total marks are out of 200. So there are some blanks in the table which shows that we are not given what kind of cutoff will be there for that particular section corresponding to that particular college. So we can assume anything, I mean, since there is no cutoff there. So let us take question number 1. Bhama got calls from all colleges. What could be the minimum aggregate marks obtained by her? Now, this is really tough one. Since Bhama has got calls from all the colleges, that means whatever the table marks are given in terms of sectional cutoff, he should clear that. So if you look at section A, in college 1, it is 42, in college 4, it is 43, and in college 5, it is 45. So in other words, he must get 45 marks in section A, then only he will clear the cutoff of section A in all the colleges, because 45 is the highest across the column. Please understand. Similarly, she should get 45 in section B as well, because 45 is the highest as far as the column of section B is concerned. She should get 46 in section C, and by the same logic, she should get 45 in section D. So the total, the minimum she is getting is 45 plus 45 plus 46 plus 45. So the answer is 181 marks. And we can check that 181 is the highest, is clearing the cutoff of all the, colleges as far as aggregate total is concerned. Okay, let's take the next question. Charlie got calls from two colleges. What could be the minimum marks obtained by him in a section, in any of the section? So again, there are options given. Now, if you look at the aggregate cutoff, the lowest two are 171 and 175. So if Charlie gets 175, he will clear the cutoff in the two colleges, which are college 3 as well as college 2. So my job is just to somehow fit in 175 marks. So if you look at the college 2, there are only two cutoff given, which is in section B and section C, 45 marks each. And in college 3, there is only one cutoff, which is in section C, which is 46 marks. So in other words, in both the colleges, section A as well as section D, there is no requirement as such. And therefore, I have got lot of room to play around. And this is the beauty of this question. So what I'll do is, I will assume that he is getting 50, 50, 50 marks in the three sections, and to get a total of 175, he is just getting 25 marks in any of the section of section A or section D, and it will fit in all the criteria. So the minimum marks are 25. Okay, let's take one more. Aditya did not get a call from even a single college. What could be the maximum aggregate marks obtained by him? So here I want to find the maximum marks given he has not got a call from a single college. So what I'll do is, if you take the columns of section C and section D, they cover all the colleges. So my job is just to make sure that he is not clearing the sectional cutoff in all the colleges. So what I'll do is, if you see section C, the minimum are 42, 45, 46 and 43. The lowest is 42. So I will assume that Aditya has got 41 marks in section C, and therefore he will not clear the cutoff for college 1, college 2, college 3 and college 5. So coming to college 4 and 6, there is section D which is covering these two colleges and the minimum is 44. So I will make Aditya get 43 marks. And therefore, Aditya will not clear any of the colleges as far as the sectional cutoff of C and D is concerned. So the total maximum of Aditya will be 41 in section C plus 43 in section D plus 50-50 in section A and B because I want to maximize his score. And therefore, if I add all of them, I get 184 as the answer. Thank you.